Hi there, Stephanie from Design Plus Code. In this first video of this three-part series about notifications, we will learn how to set up Firebase Cloud Messaging as a provider server to send push notifications to the users of our application. Push notifications, or remote notifications, are a core part of any application. There are notifications sent to your users through your provider server and the Apple Push Notification Service. Push notifications might seem scary at first since they require a lot of setup, from authentication keys, setting up your own server, asking for permission from the user, to, finally, sending the notification itself. Luckily, if you already have Firebase enabled in your project, you can use Firebase Cloud Messaging to send push notifications to your users through the Firebase console. In this first section of the push notification series, let's see how to set up Firebase Cloud Messaging and enable push notifications in our Xcode project. Once you created your Xcode project, the first thing you need to make sure is that you already have Firebase enabled in your project. You can read the Firebase auth section of this handbook to learn how to set up Firebase in your SwiftUI project. When adding the Firebase SDK to your project, make sure that you check the Firebase Analytics as well as the Firebase Messaging options so you can connect to Firebase Cloud Messaging in your application. Before we continue, you also need to make sure that you're part of the Apple Developer Program, as some features aren't available to free users, including sending push notifications. You can check your program type by going to your Apple Developer account, clicking on Membership, and you will see on the first line that you are part of the Apple Developer Program or not. If you aren't part of it, you can enroll at developer.apple.com/programs/enroll. In order to be able to send push notifications to your users, you'll need to create an Apple Push Notifications service key. To do so, you'll have to navigate to developer.apple.com/account to access your developer account. Next, you will need to click on Certificates, Identifiers, and Profiles, and then navigate to Keys. Once on this page, you will need to click on the plus sign next to the keys word and create a new key. Here, you'll give it any name that you want, and you will click on Enable Apple Push Notifications Service. Remember that you can only have two Apple Push Notifications service keys per Apple developer team. So as you can see, I have already reached the maximum allowed number of keys for this service. So once you created your new key, you will see at the top left corner that you will be able to download your APN's authentication key. You will need to save it in a secure place because you'll need it later and it's only a one-time download. So if you come back later, you won't be able to download it and you'll need to create a new key. For example, here I have a APN staging key and I also have a key ID. And as you can see, the download button is grayed out and I can download the APN's authentication key. So remember to download it and save it securely. Using the APNs authentication key we just created, we'll need to link it to Firebase Cloud Messaging. To do so, head over to your Firebase console and next to Project Overview, click on the gear icon, then on Project Settings. In here, you will need to click on the Cloud Messaging tab and then scroll down to iOS App Configuration. As you can see, here you can add your APNs authentication key, or you can also add an APNs certificate, which is the old way. Since we downloaded an APNs authentication key in the last step, we will need to upload it. So once you click on upload, you can browse your Finder to find the .p8 file that you just downloaded from the Apple developer website. You will also need to provide the key ID that you can find under the keys tab and then right here. You will also need to provide the team ID. For the team ID, you will need to go to developer.apple.com/account and click on membership. You will see on the third line your team ID. And once you uploaded your APNs auth key, added the required ID, you will be able to upload everything. The last thing we need to do for the setup of push notifications in our application is to add the capabilities in our project. So for this tutorial, we'll only focus on iOS, so we'll click on iOS. Then under Sign In and Capabilities, we will add a new capability. So search for Push Notifications and double-click on that. Next, we'll also need to add Background Modes. So search for Background and double-click on Background Modes. In here, you will need to check Background Fetch and Remote Notifications. This will allow us to send notifications from our server, which is Firebase Cloud Messaging, to our users. So open your Xcode project and navigate to your project name app.swift file. It's usually in the shared folder. In here, we will need to import three things. So the first thing is SwiftUI and it's already imported. The second thing is to import Firebase. And then we'll need to import the user notifications. Next, we'll need to create our app delegate. So head over to the text content of this section to copy the first part of the app delegate code. And I will paste it just below my app structure here. So this is the first part of the app delegate. Then scroll down in the text content and you will find an extension on app delegate, which will conform to the messaging delegate. This here will print our device token, which will be useful for testing notifications in Firebase Cloud Messaging. Lastly, copy the last extension in the text content of this section and paste it below. This extension will conform to a UN Notification Center delegate. So think of it as a notification center, and this is where everything related to the notifications are handled. So as you can see, there's no more error. We had some error when we just pasted the first app delegate, but now that we added the extensions, we fixed the errors. So in our first app delegate here, after the application finished launching, we are configuring Firebase and then we are adding the messaging delegate here and asking the user for permission to send them notifications. If you put the Firebase configure in the init in your application structure here, remove it and put it in the did finish launching with option here. Next, we will need to link our app delegate to our application. So what we will do is create a new line and then write at UI application delegate adapter. And then you'll open the parentheses and write app delegate.self var app delegate. So now you linked your AppDelegate class to your application structure here. Now that we added everything related to the AppDelegate, we simply need to build and run our application on an actual device. Because remember that push notifications don't work on the simulator. So you'll need to connect your iPhone to your Mac and test it like so. So we'll click on play here and it will install on my phone. So this is my phone, and as you can see, the coffee app has been installed. And here, since I installed it for the first time since adding the app delegate, I'm prompted with a message that asked me if I would like to receive notifications from this application. So I will click on allow, and then head back to your Xcode. In the console, you will see that a device token has been printed. This device token is like an address to your device, and it is unique to each device. Also, every time that you uninstall and reinstall the application on your phone, this device token will be regenerated. So I will copy this token because I will need it in the next step. Head to the Firebase console of your project, and on the left side, scroll down to Cloud Messaging and click on that. In here, you will see a banner and a button that tells you to send your first message. So we will click on that. We will use the device token that we just copied before to send a test notification to our device. So the first thing we will test is to send a notification while our application is on the foreground. So when it's open like this. So for the title, I will write notification. And for the text, I will write, this is my first notification. And then I will send a test message and I will paste the device token that I copied from the Xcode console before and click on the plus sign. Then I will simply click on test and I should receive a notification on my device. So as you can see, I got my notification while my app was in foreground. Let's test it when it's on the background. So when the application is still open here and I didn't force quit it and it's still running in the background. So I will write this as my second notification and send a test message, and the device token is the same because I didn't delete my application. So I will click on test. And as you can see, I got my notification as well. The last thing we need to test is to test when the app is closed. So when the user kills the app. So I will change the text to this is my third notification and send a test message to the same device. So as you can see, I got my notification as well. Firebase Cloud Messaging works hand in hand with Firebase Analytics. So to make sure that Firebase Cloud Messaging works correctly in production mode, we'll need to make sure that we have the Firebase Analytics package in our project and enable it in the Firebase console if it's not enabled yet. So to check if you already have this package in your project, you simply need to go to your application, click on your target, and then under General, you will scroll down to Frameworks, Libraries, and Embedded Content. If you see Firebase Analytics, then you're good. If you don't already have Firebase installed in your application, you'll need to install it. If you already have Firebase installed, but you don't have the Firebase Analytics package, you can simply click on the plus sign here, and under Firebase package, you will choose Firebase Analytics and add it. However, currently there is a known issue with Firebase Analytics that might raise a validation error when you're archiving your project to eventually distribute it in the App Store or on test flight. And the error displayed is found an unexpected MacO header code. As a workaround to solve this issue, you can navigate to your project name here and you will click on Edit Scheme and then you will click on Archive. Click on the chevron here and click on Post Actions. Then you will add a new action, which will be a new run script action. And then you will select your target, so iOS. And you'll simply need to paste the script that you can find in the text content below. So you paste it here. And this code will simply remove all the artifacts that cause the validation error when you're trying to validate your application. Then you click on close and everything should be good when you'll be archiving your project. Then you also need to make sure that you have Firebase Analytics enabled in your Firebase project. So to check if it's already enabled, you will go to your Firebase console. And then on the left side, you will scroll down and under Analytics, you will click on Dashboard. If you see your dashboard, it means that it is already enabled. And if you see a banner that says Analytics and get detailed analytics to measure and analyze how users engage with your apps, you simply click on Enable Google Analytics and follow the easy steps to set up Google Analytics in your project. Before you release your application, you will need to click on the entitlement files here, and for APS environment, you'll need to change it to production mode. Because according to Apple's documentation, the APS environment entitlement is a key that is automatically generated by Xcode when you enable push notifications in your project, and by default, it will be set to development. However, when you release your application, you want the environment to be production, so you'll need to change it manually. Finally, after everything is set up, simply release your application either in the App Store or on test flight. Then navigate to the notification composer in the Firebase console and we'll create our first notification campaign. So for this notification, I will write new notification as the title, and for the notification text, I will write hello from Firebase. Then I won't send a test message because I will send a campaign. So a campaign will send the notification to all the users who have this application installed on their device. So then I will click on next. For the target, you can either select a user segment or a topic. If you subscribe your users to a specific topic, then you can write the topic here. But for this tutorial, I will select the user segment and I will select all the users who have my application, so the coffee app, installed on their device. Then I will click on next. And for scheduling, you can schedule when you want to send your notification. So you can schedule for another date, or you can also send recurring notifications. So for example, you can send a notification every day to your users. However, this is not really good user experience because you'll be spamming them. So for this tutorial, I will keep it now and then click on next. For the conversion events, this is optional, as you can see that is written here. And this is if you want to gather some data for your analytics. However, for this tutorial, I won't add any conversion event. Then the last step is the additional options. For example, you can add some key value pairs if you want to send some custom data to your application. You can also enable the sound, and you can also add an iOS badge. So an iOS badge is a badge on the top right corner of your application logo here. And the expiry is when you want the notification campaign to end. So Firebase will stop trying to send notifications to the devices that have your application installed. So for me, I will put 1 day. Then I will click on review and publish it. So it took some time, but I got my notification from my notification campaign. So I hope that you learned something new in this 3-part push notification series, and don't hesitate to head over to all the other sections of this SwiftUI handbook to learn more about other topics on SwiftUI.